Have mercy for the spirit still praying for me. Times hard, don't forgive me if I smell funny. Sleeping in cars, they be real with no hotel money. Louis Vuitton, you just get it cause your man want it. Pictures and captions let me know that you would tell something. Middle school bitches used to call me Bruce. Now it's stretch, Maybachs in the coupes too. Like jewels, I'm just trying to pack a deuce. Diplomats, Arabic, yeah, I'm making my moves. Broke the richest fucking bitches in my favorite shoes. She thought I had a seizure, told her April Fools. Fuck a lawsuit, bitch, I'm trying to make the news. Master Muhammad sold silks going door to door. Giving knowledge to the brothers fed who wanted more. We a nation of brothers, such a wonderful force. Go straight to the Quran if you wanted the source. I know God's so proud you becoming the boss. Cold world, but the flows keep a nigga warm. We was sleeping on the floors when it used to storm. I just wanna get a home for my only mom. It's a dream to make her proud of her only son. It's a dream to make her proud of her only son. Make her proud of her only son. It's a dream to make her proud of her only son.
It's about that time. Light sparkle off my jewelry. It's about that shine. Money busts out every pocket. It's about that grind. A schooling dudes, especially when a nigga third eye blind. Can give a fuck about what's yours. Only concerned about mine, nigga. He's steaming like all his hypnosis is heavy. If this can kill, I'll probably die countless deaths already. Gillette razor sharp suited, shooting star like a comet. Swag gave birth to millions like Master Farah Muhammad Boss. Looking relaxed like I don't want to be moving. I thank God for the blessings and paths paved as I journey through a jungle of lions so unscathed. Until I speak in tongues when I visit my aunt's grave. And hustle like a genius for strength of a man's slave. It gets deeper while they singing his praise. Walk with me now. I bless the hood while I keep on banging them harder. Unconditional to love as a daughter's love for a father. And dream flying through the clouds on the planes that I charter. And documenting moments of time becoming a martyr while I merge corporations expanding a little larger now. For the sole purpose my people can all eat. Through the acts of desperate folks occupying up Wall Street. But I'm torn while in the studio giving you all heat. And their ignorance is bliss. Busy saying they born straight on their hands and knees. Just like they walking on 4 feet. Damn. Look what they really turning us into. A savage smelling blood while malfunctioning in the mental. With baggage through the mud that they dragging until they settle. I rational up success when I'm sniffing a rose petal. If you violate the truth in your body, you fill a metal. Listen to these words with the power to fuel rockets. Just in the same time, it's so perfect for me to drop this. It's getting to the point where they're begging the kid to stop it. It's hard to honor such requests when you're bathing in profit. With this shit I said, it's come to pass. Now they calling me prophet, Lord. Special how I touch the people when I'm speaking. So precious like a moment of watching a baby sleeping. Infectious like opponents that's always catching a beating. Through journeys that I travel and missions I be completing. Put the mic down and leave it with mama for safekeeping. Let me hear that shit again, son.
Busta Rhymes off his new album. Joint was dope. Joint was dope. Y'all should go check it out. That's a song he did with Rick Ross. Y'all need to go check out his new album that he dropped. He really went all the way out on this album, and I have to admit, it's a dope album. So when you guys get a chance, make sure you check the brother out. Aside from that, I want to do this live early because I got to catch his verses today with Young Jeezy and Gucci. And y'all got to understand there's history there because at that time I was at the top of my game as a hip hop journalist. I was in Atlanta and I was in all the mix of that drama. You know what I'm saying? So I actually had a chance to speak to both of these guys and on several different occasions in my career, but especially during all that time period when all that was going on. So it's really interesting the fact that these two actually squashed their beef and they're actually going to do a versus. So I'm letting y'all know I'm going to keep it a buck 50. I'm doing this live before this versus start. Okay, because I'm going to be there for that. I'm just going to keep it a buck. How y'all doing? This is your girl, Isis Wisdom of ElevatedRadio.fm on IG Live, and I will send this over to my YouTube channel as well. Also, want to make you guys aware, I got a big, big interview with Dr. Phil Valentine coming up on the 29th of this month. So, and that's going to be on YouTube. That's not going to be here on Instagram. That's going to be on my YouTube channel with Isis Wisdom Show. So make sure you stay tuned to that, because that thing is going to be retarded. And I want to get the stuff out the way, because I see YouTube and Instagram is updating all their stuff before the 21st, which I think is funny. So I want to hurry up and get my stuff in while I can. Spiritual baddie, what up, mama? What's going on? All right, so I got some downloads. I got some information. I bounced some things off of one of my goddaughters who's a medium as well. And some information kind of came to me here recently, probably within like the last 48 hours. And what I want to talk about is, and it does pertain to not only just the time period for what's coming up in December, but it also pertains to in life in general, because there are some information, some messages that I want to give to those that have the ability to hear this message. This message is not for individuals that can't process the message. This is for those actually is going to process the message today. Okay, so I'm speaking specifically to you. What we're going to talk about is spirituality, humility, being humble, not just your shadow work, but how those three major key components can be the determination as to whether or not you're going to make it or you're not. And it's very important that you get these key lessons here for those that have the ability to hear, because there are some things I witnessed here recently that inspired me to come out and speak about this. First and foremost, let me just say this one thing. Ladies and gentlemen, we're all spiritual beings. Every single last one of us are. Whether or not you were aware of it or not, I know a lot of you guys are new. A lot of you guys are just waking up to this information as far as spirituality and the things that are taking place. But there are three key components that one must have. Okay? And you first must come to the realization and the acceptance that you have always been a spiritual being. And even though these things weren't taught to you in the proper manner, I'm going to share this information with you and hope that you guys take it with you off this live. What does it mean when I say, what I mean when I say spirituality as a priest? We have to understand that there are so many different things that are going on around us that we just simply don't know everything. You don't know everything. I don't know everything. Okay? You have to have your mind open like a child to even receive the blessings that are supposed to come to you. And I see a lot of people missing out on their blessings. I see a lot of people not even being able to recognize a blessing when it comes because they're so closed-minded. Their walls are up immediately. They don't even realize that when they're praying and they're asking for assistance because of the conditions that they may have been under, that the ancestors will hear, the creator's going to hear, the spirits are going to hear, the ethers are going to hear, your ancestors are going to hear, and they're going to put somebody in your path to help you. But what I've been running into is individuals that are not really ready for what they're asking for because they don't understand how it works. Now, there is many different forms of spirituality. Okay? You have those that are in religion, those that practice spiritual traditions. The bottom line is that if you are asking for assistance and you've been praying for assistance, and that assistance comes, you have to have enough humility to understand some things that you just don't know every damn thing. So when a person that you come to, that you ask for assistance, takes the time out of their life, sacrifices their time and their energy to come and assist you, It is your responsibility to make sure that you receive all the messages that you're supposed to receive. So let me give an example. As a Nephi priestess, I help people all the time with issues. And you guys have heard me say 1,000 times over that this is not a tarot reading. This is not a psychic reading. That means you do not come to me and seek out a reading from me if you are not ready to change your life, because you're wasting my time. And not only are you wasting my time, you're wasting your time. I'm not going to be the one that's going to come to you and tell you what you want to hear. And don't get pissed off at me when Spirit gives you a message that you don't want to hear. Because I'm going to tell y'all something about Spirit and how it works. Spirit don't give a, doesn't give two F's about what you feel you should, that you want to hear. What they're there to do is give you the necessary messages for warnings, the necessary messages to better your health, the necessary messages to better your mental health, the necessary messages to build, to help you with your spiritual health. They give you taboos. They give you, they let you know things to come. Sometimes when a message comes, it may not be always positive, but here's the thing with that. When you come in this direction, as a Nephi priest, we're here to change the dynamic of the energy so things can come to you to assist you. We're not here to tell you things that's gonna make you feel a certain type of way. We're here to tell you the message from the Spirit, and the Spirit don't give a damn about your feelings. They don't. Okay, y'all gotta understand that. Your answers don't give a damn about your feelings either. And I'm gonna tell y'all something. Answers be quick to go upside your head when your ass is hard-headed and you don't listen. And you just look at it like, oh, that's just a bad thing that happened, or this happened, blah, blah, blah. Sometimes your ancestors will scold you and beat your ass. They will do that. And your lack of knowledge is not going to stop that ass whipping from coming. Okay. So Instagram hit me up over some posts that somebody else posted. It wasn't mine. It was a story that I put in there, that I put up in my Instagram. And it said that something about somebody doing sale for illegal goods. I didn't do that. That's not coming from me. But anyway, I had to stop for a minute because they put it up. Are y'all there? Are y'all there? Yeah, I didn't do that. I don't know what they're talking about. I didn't put that post up there. Yeah, Standalone Kings had put a story up. And then you know how you tag a post. I'm just going through the list and just kind of, you know, sharing stories. But I didn't put that up there like I'm selling, because I don't have nothing to do with that. Okay, I'm good now. Okay, they just put that up there, but I ain't, look, hey, AG, that ain't me, fam. You know what I'm saying? Don't get me caught up in some stuff. Y'all need to go to the individual that posted that. That ain't got nothing to do with me. But anyway, like I was saying, then I hear the story of people that don't have any knowledge of give and take in spirituality. Let me break something down to y'all. There's not going to be, when it comes to universal law, and this is the thing that you guys got to understand about universal law. Universal law means that you give and take. If you go to your ancestors and you need some assistance, you're going to have to cook them some food, get them some liquor, get them some tobacco, get them all types of stuff that they're going to need, okay, in order for them to assist you. That's the way that go. So there's no such thing as you're going to do everything for me, but I'm not going to do it for myself, and you're the one with the issues. That's your shit. So as a priest, if I say to you, you got to pay for your shit, that's exactly what the hell your ass is going to do. Why? One, my energy has to be compensated. My wherewithal, my knowledge base has to be compensated. My time has to be compensated. And not to mention, I got to go out here and buy supplies to do your work. This is your shit. Because this is how I roll. I don't have to help you. Because if you knew how to do it for yourself, you wouldn't have came to me in the first place. That's how that go. Now, you have some people, so I feel like I shouldn't have to pay for this, that, and the third. And I'm like, well, okay, well, check this out. Take your ass on over there and get yourself a psychic reading or go see a tarot reader. But you don't come to those who practice the ATRs talking about you need some help and then get on one when I'm following strict protocol. That's not how this works. I want you guys to understand that. And in life, when it comes to spirituality, y'all better get that mentality out of your head that you think somebody owes you something. Because it's called transference of energy. Y'all know what that is? Y'all know what that means when I speak about transference of energy? It means that when a person steps out there to assist you, they inherit all your bullshit, all your bad luck, all your blockages, and everything that you got going on with you. From an energetic perspective that you have accumulated on your own because your ass wasn't acting right. And you get your own karma built up. And you causing problems within yourself. So then you come to the priest to ask us to help you and clear your shit out. But you think that we're supposed to take everything that comes with that for free. Y'all better get out my damn face with that bullshit. I want to make sure you guys are clear. You come to us when you're ready to change your life. You go to tarot readings and everybody else when you want to hear what the hell you want to hear. But when it comes to spirit, you can't manipulate spirit. You can't manipulate the messages that come from spirit. You can't manipulate the messages that come from God. Especially when I'm chanting on you and I'm opening up the heavens to get the messages, you can't manipulate them. Okay? You can't do it. And just as sure as I'm having this conversation with you on this phone, when that message and the information comes out from us, that shit's going to come to pass, whether you do something about it or you don't. You have to have enough humility to receive the message, do the work, and move on with your life. This is not about ego. I'm not in competition with you. I'm here to assist you to get to where you got to go. And too many times I've seen people on some, well, I just want to have the experience of getting a reading from Isis, but then don't want to do the work that they're supposed to do. Do not come to me anymore, because I got a little trick for that now. I got a little trick for that now. There's a few of y'all I'm going to be coming back around to see if you're really about that life. Because if you're not about that life, I'll be gladly to reimburse you, but you're not going to be wasting my damn time. Period. Why is that? Because once I open up heaven for you and you don't get the shit done that's supposed to be done, shit starts happening. Things could go all the way left for an individual because this is something different. So I need you guys to understand before you seek me out for any assistance, you better damn well understand you come to me when you're ready to go full throttle and do what the hell you got to do because you're really ready to make a real change. That you're ready to really force yourself because in any African tradition, it forces you to deal with yourself and your bullshit. Okay? They're going to tell you the message you need to know. You make the necessary adjustments and changes. And that's something that we all should be striving to do for our lives, period. Y'all mentally masturbating out here too much. Because you think it's playtime. Do you understand that the world that we're getting ready to transition into is going to be a spiritual world and there's going to be a lot of you that's going to have a hard time adjusting? There's going to be a lot of you having a hard time adjusting because you haven't done your shadow work. There's going to be a lot of you having a hard time adjusting because you won't face yourself. Because you want things to be done as they've always been done. And the message I'm trying to get out to you guys is this. The old way is not going to work for you anymore. It will not work for where we're going. It's not going to happen. And I put these messages out there to prep you guys. For you guys to understand this. We are moving into a world of spirituality all the way across the board. That means if you still have a 3D mindset coming into 5D consciousness, you're in trouble. You're in trouble physically because you're going to feel sick. You're in trouble mentally because it's going to drive you crazy if you cannot adjust. This is real talk. There's going to be some of y'all that's going to make it through the transition. There's going to be some of y'all that are not going to make it through the transition, or you're going to have a hard time making it through the transition because you can't be humble enough and accepting enough and have enough humility and have enough gratefulness to to say, thank you for bringing people into my life to assist me to get to the next level. Because you can't do this by yourself, y'all. You're going to need some help to guide you in the proper direction. Whether it's me, whether it's an Nephi priest, whether it's someone that's practicing voodoo, whether it's someone that's doing something else. I don't care what it is. Whether it's Christianity, whether it's Islam. I don't care what it is. I don't care. What I'm saying to you is that there has to be some type of spirituality within you in order for you to adjust going into the transition of next year. That's the point that I'm trying to make here. And a lot of y'all miss your blessings because your walls go up. When somebody tells you you don't want to hear, your walls go up. You miss the blessing. You wouldn't even know a blessing if it smacks you in your face because you didn't throw your blessing away. You wouldn't know if it smacks you in your head. I'm trying to get you guys to understand that go inward. Wake up in the morning and tell the Creator how grateful you are that you're alive, because those people are what's going to make it into that transition. Those people that have enough humility to understand and be grateful that they're even still alive at this point, those people are going to make it through that transition. I'm even beginning to question whether or not, from a health perspective, yeah, you definitely want to be on your A game. But let's just say you're in your A game, right, with your health, right? Let's say you're on your A game, you know what I'm saying? You're doing your monatomic gold, you're doing all that stuff, right? But you ain't did your shadow work. But you have no humility. But your mind is not open and receiving to learning new things. You won't make it for that transition. There are going to be people that's going to make it into that transition that's going to think that they shouldn't have made it. And there's going to be people that thought that they prepped enough to think that they're going to make it, then ain't going to make it. That is what was revealed to me today. Spirit was talking to me through somebody else. Spirit was talking to me through the ethers. Spirit had a message for me all the way across the board. And I got the message loud and clear. Very loud. Very clear. I had been meditating today. Some more information came to me that I didn't even know that blew my wig back, that my daughter gave me yesterday, that just kind of had me sitting still for a minute. Like I literally was sitting up there stuck. And some of you guys might think, well, damn, how did you not know that? But I really didn't know. You know what I'm saying? My daughter's, you know, she's 28 years old. You know, I really didn't know the information. But I'm gonna share something with y'all. My born name is Michelle. Had a hard time with that name for a long time. Had a hard time with it. Hated it. Hated it. Right? My daughter tells me yesterday that my name actually means in the likeness of God in Hebrew. That really blew my wig back. Because I had no idea that's what that meant. And it also means, another definition of it means the opposite of Michael, the angel Michael, is Michelle. So you got Michael, Michelle. Her father's name is Michael. My name is Michelle. Her name is Malaika, which means angels. And she told us her name before she was even born. So this is when I found out, when I started putting pieces together later, other information started coming back to conversations I had with my great-grandmother from the grave, spirit, talking to ancestors, and her revealing certain things to me. And it really kind of blew my wig back a lot. But I had no idea that that's what my name meant. But then it started making sense to me as to my journey on Earth. Why I'm here, what it is I'm supposed to do, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It made so much sense. But for a long time, I was rejecting that name for a very, very long time. I mean, years of rejecting it. Years of rejecting it. So when that revelation came to me, you know, it just kind of put some things into perspective. And this is when more information started coming to me. And I just feel like, you know, it just really inspired me to come and have a real deep, divine conversation with you guys about humility. So I got humble real quick when she told me that. It just kind of was like, wow. So I was born and I was destined to do what it is that I'm doing. Born out of the womb to do this, to help people. And when people come to me and they attack and they project because they haven't dealt with their own shadow work, you know, I take a step back because as a priest, you know, we understand human condition. As a person who's worked in the music business for many years, I understand human condition, meaning that the skin is tough enough for me not to even get caught up in that shit emotionally, because I understand the human condition and what's really going on with those individuals. I get it. But I'm going to tell y'all something. It ain't wise to project your stuff onto everybody else. The wise thing to do is deal with self. Have enough humility to deal with yourself. Ask the creator for help. And when the help comes to you, accept the help. Don't fight the person who's trying to help you, because they're telling you something that you don't want to hear. Accept the information and be glad that you got the warnings and be grateful for that. When you show spirit that you're not grateful, let me tell you what happens to that person. Their protection comes down. Did you know that? When you walk around in life and you're ungrateful, your protection comes down. Anything's able to happen to you because you're not living a righteous life. You're not putting spirit first. You're not putting humility first. You're not putting gratitude first. You're not doing any of these things. I sense that in this new world that's coming, I sense that, you know, that old saying that says the meek shall inherit the earth. That's true. Let me tell you who the meek are. It's those that are humble. Those that show gratitude. Those that help others. Those that are smart enough and wise enough to know when to use their ego and when not to. I got a feeling that's the way that's going to go. I think that that's something that everybody needs to take away from them today, because the way this thing is going to come, you know, remember when they said that no one knows the hour or the day, quote unquote, when the Lord's going to come? Okay, that's a metaphor, right? No one knows the day or the time. You know, we're all waiting for this big thing to happen, but it's a strong possibility that this thing could go a different way. Let me give an example. My goddaughter shared with me about a dream that she had, and it was deep to me because I was like, damn, it just kind of had me stuck for a minute. Like, she shared a dream with me she had. She said that she had a dream about this cloud that had rainbows over it. And she saw people leaving. Some people made it over. Some people died. What stood out to me was the cloud and the rainbow. To me, the rainbow is the radiation, right? You remember that story in scripture where they talked about how everybody had to put blood on the front door of their houses because the Lord was going to come and take the firstborns? That's what that reminded me of. That's what it reminded me of. It reminded me of that. Like, when she said she saw it in the cloud, I said, damn, that's deep. So, you know, what I'm saying to you is that I think that everybody just needs to keep their wits about them in terms of whatever's going to happen, whatever's going to happen. I think that people need to really get the message that this is about a love frequency. And in order for you to operate a love frequency, you got to tap into those three things that I mentioned earlier. This is jewels and I'm dropping for y'all. Okay? Straight up jewels. Spiritual jewels. You guys have got to start getting a lot more spiritual. You got to start becoming a lot more grateful. You got to start showing a whole lot more gratitude. And more importantly, you got to have acceptance of where you are. You have to have acceptance that there's certain things you don't have control over. We all they like to think that we have control over this and control over that, when the truth of the matter is we don't. You can get 1,000 readings from a tarot reader or a psychic reader, it still doesn't mean you have control of an outcome. So, I'm just saying to you that I need you guys to really take heed about what it is I'm saying here. This is important. I want you guys, when you get a chance, as soon as you can, for those of you who have your ancestor altar set up, y'all need to go have a conversation with them. Y'all need to sit down and have a conversation with them on a real level. And say, if I'm not doing something right, y'all need to help me get it together. And tell them that you're grateful that you're even here, because if it wasn't for them, you wouldn't even be here right now. Let them know. Thank them for their protection and their guidance. Because you had to have some type of protection and guidance along the way. And this plane. I want you guys to understand. People don't realize that spiritual things cause a lot of people issues. But spiritual things also can cause a lot of people a lot of joy and happiness. It's really based on your knowledge base. Okay? But you guys have no idea how many times I've helped people and the things I see come out on them and things that are causing certain things on people. People out here throwing witchcraft on folks left and right. And you got those who don't have no belief in it whatsoever, or they're afraid of it or whatever it is. And what those individuals that don't believe, you know what they don't understand? They don't understand that they don't have the necessary wherewithal, or they don't have the protection in place in order for it to avoid certain situations. So let me give an example. Somebody gets into a car accident. You think it was something normal for that person to get into a car accident. It was something by chance, right? But little do you know, somebody that hates you that had some skills in that arena sent some energy to you to take your ass right on up out of here. That's how real this shit is. When it comes to sickness, when it comes to all different types of things, you don't know what the cause of that is. But more often than not, what you begin to start realizing is when you come down the path of spirituality, is you begin to start seeing that people have spiritual problems that are affecting them in the physical world. Okay? And your lack of knowledge is going to be the thing that determines how you process and how you move forward in life. Your lack of knowledge. Now, you don't have to believe nothing that I'm telling you. Okay? I'm just here to open up your eyes. You don't have to believe nothing that I'm telling you. You can continue to keep moving forward as if you don't hear this conversation, as if this lie don't mean nothing to you or whatever. You can continue to move forward. I don't care how you move. I am here to deliver a message to those that have the ability to hear what I'm saying. So they have the necessary tools to make sure that they're prepared for whatever's coming between the 21st and the 25th. Because I'm telling y'all, do not think for a second that the powers that be don't know what's coming. Because they were told, they had a choice. And that choice was to change over certain things, change the guard, or deal with the consequences of what's going to happen to you if you don't. And they don't understand that this is not something that they can escape. You can hide in all the tunnels that you want to. You can hide in your house. It doesn't matter where your ass is going. It's irrelevant, because the sun is intelligence. Okay? The sun is a living being, a living entity. There are spirits on the sun. And as it's sending out radiation, that radiation that's being sent out is intelligence. And as it's sending out radiation, it's scanning people. You're being scanned. Y'all didn't know nothing about that, did you? Where can I read about that at? That's why they're moving so fast in their operations. You damn right that's why they're doing it. Because their whole thing is, they done did so much, it's like, well, if I'm going to go out, I'm going to take as many people out as I possibly can. There's nothing I can do about it. You got individuals in place. Like I said before, there's going to be a lot of people that you know that you ain't going to see next year, that you know this year, that you're not going to see next year. Okay? When you go out there and you sun gaze, and for those of you who are trying to do the sun gaze, let me give you some instructions on how to do this, because some of y'all out here just tearing your damn eyeballs up because you don't know how to do it properly. Okay, you're tearing your eyeballs up. If you want to go out here and you want to sun gaze, the best time to sun gaze is when the sun is first rising and then when it's setting. That's the best time to sun gaze, because this is when you'll be able to see the things that have been hidden to your eye. Because the sun is not what you think that it is. Okay? It's not what you think that it is. And what a lot of people don't realize is that the heat that you feel coming on the planet is actually coming from the ground of the planet and not the top of the planet. Metaphysics 101. Okay? The sun, imagine this. Think about it like this. If you had a light and it was shining on, let's say, a mirror, not a mirror, but a piece of glass, and you beam it down on something, it's going to heat whatever that is up, right? You guys are not taking the time out to understand what the ground of the earth actually really is. And that's part of the reason why the ground is much more hotter than it is when the sun coming down. It's actually, the heat is actually coming up and it's rising up, okay? And because we're under a dome, then it's coming right back down. So we've been lied to from NASA. We've been lied to by mainstream scientists. We've been lied to in terms of how this thing works. When we speak about the black sun, you do have the black sun inside the earth, inside the core of the earth. That's real talk. It's a mirror. Boom! That's why we say, so above, so below. Now you know where that comes from. Whether or not military members are going to be forced to vaccinate or not is irrelevant to the subject that I'm talking about. It's irrelevant. None of the stuff that you guys are worried about is irrelevant. It's totally irrelevant. It doesn't even mean nothing. Let me just say this one thing, though. You're going to have certain factions and certain forces that's going to try to start this whole big old lock thing down thing, and it ain't going to work this next going around. It ain't going to go down. It ain't going to go down like that. It's going to be shut down. We are going to shut it down. Okay, just so you know, they're going to have to back up off of us. Okay, because when the people's frequency is high enough, and you piss us off enough, it's going to be a whole different thing going on. It ain't going to be like it was before. Nothing is going to be as it was before. How the planet looked is going to even be different. And I talked about that months ago. That things are going to be looking the same but different. So that's how you're going to know a shift did take place, because things are going to look the same but different. I talked about that on my previous lives. Someone said, what do you buy? You won't see people. Are they going to pass away? Are you listening to the message? Listen, the one thing I can't do is I cannot think for you. A lot of you guys hit me up with questions where you just want me to think for you, and I can't do that for you. You're going to have to learn how to start thinking for yourself. I can't do that for you. You have to learn how to get the message and really listen and listen to what is being said. But you have to have a mind to start thinking for yourself. Now, I understand that some of you guys need to be guided. I get that aspect of it. I can't be everyone's mentor. It's impossible for me to be everyone's mentor. So these lives are information that are being given to you where you can tap into it, get the necessary information and things that you need to get. And then you go ahead, you do your research off the information. Some of this information I get from downloads. Okay? So, I need you guys to understand that I am getting I'm connected to something that gives me information. Now, there's some good information. There's some books that are out there, too, that you can read about. You know what I'm saying? But some of this information as it pertains to things that are coming about right now, you're not really going to find in the book. But there are other scholars that are talking about the same things I'm talking about right now. Okay? I just delivered it in my own way according to the way the information is given to me. And then I disseminate the information and then turn around and give it to y'all. Okay? We are headed into a galactic society. Think Star Trek. We are headed in that direction. We most certainly are. The thing is that what I want to have you guys understand that this is nothing new under the sun. Nothing is new under the sun. When I say nothing is new, I absolutely mean nothing is new under the sun. In other words, we already had all the technology. All the technology that you see these guys using right now, where do you think they got the technology from? They got it from interdimensional beings that are actually on this planet. Okay? They got it from interdimensional beings. There are other lands on this planet, other oceans on this planet that most of us are not even privy to knowing because we were taught to look at things a certain way. Earth is a plane. It's a plane, y'all. That's what it is. It's a plane. It's a plane of existence. Do you know how many planes of existence there are? A lot. And some of us will show you how to escape that plane of existence when it's time for you to leave from here in the physical realm. Okay? But right now, you're in this realm right now. And right now, this realm is deconstructing and then reconstructing itself. That's what's happening. It's deconstructing and then reconstructing itself. That means that the landscaping is going to change. Okay? When you hear me say the world as you know it is not going to be the same, well, it's not. What I want you guys to be aware of, I want you to be careful about your frequency and the things that you tune yourselves into. Try not to be tapped into the vaccine stuff because at the end of the day, you're a magnetic being and I don't want you attracting that experience to you. So try not to tap into things that make you fearful or make you feel uncomfortable. Try not to tap into that because you do have the power. You have the power to change your own reality where you're not going to have that experience. Let me give you an example of that. You may know about a warning of something that's coming up in New York City, right? You can change your reality, not in the sense of, okay, well, I'm just going to act like this isn't going to happen, but you can change your reality where you're saying, I'm not going to have that experience. So, that means when you program yourself to not have the experience, then what happens is something comes up that's going to pull you away from that. That's how that works. For y'all that don't know, that don't mean sit your ass still because you think that something's not going to manifest. That's not how that go. That just simply means that there's going to be something in you that's going to send you away from New York where you won't have that experience. Does that mean that shit ain't going to happen? It's still going to happen. You just won't be there to experience it. Now, do you understand, babies? Do you understand how this works? As long as you program your mind not to have the experience of that, you will get your ass up out of Dodge in just enough time. Something's going to pull you away. Your ancestors might open up a door, some trip might come up out the blue, or you may even just get a sixth sense of, you know what, let me go ahead and dip out. I don't know why I feel this way, but let me just go ahead and get the hell on. I don't even know why I feel like that. I'm just going to get a plan and go. or I'm going to catch, I don't know, I'm going to go visit a cousin, or they might call you, somebody might call you for you to leave out of town or something like that. That's what's going to happen. That's changing your reality. Yeah, you change your destiny. Because the Ori, in my tradition, we call the inner head the Ori, which is short for Orisha, okay? The deity inside the head. So it's the inner head inside of the outer head, okay? The deity is the one thing that has the power to change the course of your destiny. That is why in our tradition, it's Olodumare first, simply source or God, so to speak. Then comes Ori. Then comes ancestors. Then comes Orisha. Or whoever, or whatever deities you're dealing with, or whatever the hell you're dealing with. Okay? That's how that go. Even Jesus. That's how that go. It means that you should have enough common sense on how to operate your mind. You should know how to operate your mind. Nobody knows you better than you. Nobody outside of you is ever going to know you better than you. You're going to know you better than you. You may have some skilled individuals that have the ability to zone in on you and read your energy, but at the end of the day, nobody knows you better than you. So you and you alone will have the power to change your destiny. That needs to be understood. How you think is what's going to determine your success or your failures. How you think. Common sense should kick in somewhere. I heard somebody say, common sense ain't so common. That's true. That's because people don't take the time out to use their brain and think for themselves. We have got into a society and we have got into a mode where people do not know how to think for themselves. They don't know how to critically think for themselves. They don't know how to think for themselves. So they're just being led by any damn thing. That's what we mean when we say sheep. What do you think Jesus was talking about in the scripture when he said, I take my flock and my sheep, I leave my sheep here. He's saying, y'all don't have the ability to think for yourself. By even calling you that. By even deferring to you as a flock. You don't have the ability to think for yourself. The 1% looks at you how? As useless eaters. Because they see you as not having the ability and the power to think for yourself. Therefore, they feel as though that they need to think for you. And you have allowed it to happen on a collective level. By showing inaction when you see bullshit going on. Putting your head in the sand when you see things going on. Putting up with things that you know damn well is against your being and your constitution. Following rules and laws that don't even apply to you. Not taking the time out to go and educate yourself about law. Not taking the time out to go educate yourself about anything for that matter. You just go with the damn wind. And then complain when some shit happened. Because you didn't take the time out to think for yourself. Now that, my friends, is the definition of an insane person. That's insanity. Now you see all these damn zombie movies and things like that they're putting out on a consistent basis. Who do you think they're talking about? Who do you think they're talking about? They're talking about you. And then they make a mockery of you by putting things right in front of your face because they know damn well either you ain't going to get it or you're going to get it and you're not going to give a damn about it anyway. This is why I say the shadow work is so important so you begin to start learning how to love yourself so that way you give a damn. Because right now we live in a society, this thing is so far gone that people don't give a damn not even about themselves. So it's literally impossible for them to care about anybody else. It's impossible. It's impossible for the humanity side to come out of people. We've been desensitized to a lot of things. Things that should have never happened this way. That's not what this earth was for. So now she's tired. She about to shake a whole lot of bullshit up off of her. It needs to reset itself, y'all. And all I'm saying is that if you want to be a part of this reset, whatever you take away from this message today, you better damn sure remember this. You better have some humility. You better show some gratitude. And you better humble yourself. And keep a mind open. Because you don't know every damn thing. You just don't. You know what you were programmed to know. The truth of the matter is, you don't know shit. That's why I tell people all the time now, I don't know shit. I'm a kid. I'm a baby. Have the mind of a child. And you'll be able to learn the world. When you have the humility of a child. And you look at the world through a child's eyes. That inner child. Connect to that being. Apologize to that being for putting that being, for you putting him or her to the side. Because your ego couldn't get out the damn way. To get the messages that was coming in from internal. So your ego will get in the way and block you from a lot of shit. And then you complain about why things keep happening over and over and over and over and over again. Can't do it. Learn how to respect people. Respect is a major, major, major issue. Disrespect has become all too common. Some of y'all do it so much, you don't even know what the hell disrespect is. When someone says you disrespect, you don't even recognize what it is. It's so common to you. It's so normal for you to operate in that space. Disrespect. And then you want to know why the people are in the position that they're in, because they've gotten ass backwards. See, they've taught the people how to think ass backwards, so that way you never progress in life. You never see your dreams realized because you don't realize from a metaphysical standpoint you are shutting your own shit down by yourself based upon how you think. And they know this. Everything we do must produce life. That is absolutely correct. We've been taught nothing but death culture. When you watch movies, death culture. It's cool to shoot how many 50 niggas over here. That's cool. That's a cool thing to do. Oh, it's a cool thing to do because I'm the biggest and the baddest. Man, shut up. Because at the end of the day, we all bleed. And all of us, the one thing that we are promised on this earth is you're going to die one day. What is it that you want your legacy to be when you leave from here? Is your vibration going to be high enough to receive information so you don't come back here again? Because you got a choice as to whether or not you're going to come back here again. You do have a choice. But is your mind open enough to even receive the knowledge on how not to come back here again? Are you really trying to evolve? Because they got constructs put in place to make sure you never evolve to the planet or the star that you're supposed to be. So people think a star is someone that is all adored by millions of people. That ain't no damn star. That's not what a star is. They got your head twisted with that. I must be loved and I must be adored by millions of people, and millions of people think I'm the shit. But do you think you're the shit? Because I'm going to tell you something. The people that I see in positions like that are the most unhappiest people I've ever met in my life. Now, it's one thing for you to have wealth. But I need to be adored by a million people. Now I got to put on this facade because I can't let you see the human side of me. I got to put on this facade for these millions of dollars because you done sold your damn soul down the damn block. Now some of y'all selling your souls for nothing. Some of y'all are actually having 5 or 6 different personalities out here. Don't even know which one you are. For just a little bit of people around you in your circle. Oh, I feel like I got to be this person now because I got these people coming around. And I feel like I got to be this person now because I got these people coming around. And the truth of the matter is, you know what it is? You think judgment's going to come upon you from these people because you keep judging yourself. That's really what that is. You haven't come to a place of being comfortable with you and people just accepting you for you, your quirkiness and all. And you know what? For some of y'all that don't feel like that y'all belong here, that's cool too. Some of us are not from here. Some of us are from different star systems. Some of us are. You know what I'm saying? Some of us are actually literally from here. Bottom line is, you're here. You're here. I don't want to. I want to drop something. You know, I told my goddaughter, I didn't know if I was gonna drop it or not. It was live, but I'm gonna come really real here, and y'all. I don't know how y'all gonna take what I'm about to say, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Earth is a place of fallen beings, because a lot of us are the offspring of the fallen ones. Did y'all know that? Because see, if we weren't, we wouldn't even be here in an enclosed space. Right? So your offspring, a lot of us are offspring of the fallen ones. And we got an opportunity to ascend our asses right on up out of here come December. We got an opportunity to experience what we're supposed to experience. But make no mistake. Now, you have some that are sent here on a mission to do the things that I'm doing. Waking people up, helping people, serving people, whatever, right? You have some people that are here to do that, that were sent here specifically for that mission. Or you may have chosen to come down and do that so you can learn some other lessons, right? But make no mistake that some of y'all, a lot of y'all, a lot of us are descendants of the fallen ones. Which is why we're here in this enclosed caption place. Think about it. For those that really know the truth about this earth and what it is, this message is specifically for you. Okay? Specifically for you. If you really think about what I'm saying, we're in an enclosed space. That means that this place was put into quarantine. Right? Because you got a lot of beings on this planet that are extremely destructive. Or at least in this plane. Let me correct myself. In this plane that are extremely destructive. So you had certain beings that had to say, okay, you know what? We don't need this type of destruction and these other planes over here. Or these other worlds over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to seal this whole thing off. Because we don't want that over here and over here and over here and over here. We don't want to deal with that shit. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put them in a space and see how they evolve. Do they have the ability to evolve? Or are they going to de-evolve? Prison planet, that's one way to look at it. That's one way to look at it. So I'm having a real discussion with you guys here. Don't ever put yourself in a position where you think that you are so much better than anyone else, because you're not. So the smartest thing you can do is make sure you're good. And if you can make sure your family's good, you make sure your family's good by getting on a correct path for your life and your destiny. And if your family don't want to listen to you, then your family don't want to listen to you. They made their spiritual contract. It is what it is. They'll just recycle and come back because they didn't take the time out to learn the knowledge on how not to come back. But for those of us that are on that tight time, that don't have no intentions of coming back here. See, the people that are in the know, they are already doing the research right now on how to figure out how not to come back to this place. They're already putting themselves in proper position to already prepare for the transition. They already understand the love aspect. They understand the frequency. They understand the humility. They already understand these things. Their stuff is a place. They understand these things already. And just in case they don't make it past the transition, they'll at least be able to make it past the next phase when they go into the next phase of life. They'll at least be able to get the hell on from there. Okay? They're already on the move already. That needs to be understood. That's why a lot of us don't really have a lot of time to be playing around. That's why a lot of us are super serious about the things that we talk about. And we ain't got time for the bullshitters and the naysayers and those that want to get caught up in the wrong things. You want to come at the folks, throw witchcraft at folk. You want to tear somebody down. We don't have time for that energy, bro. Sis, we don't have time for that. I do not know you when you put yourself in that space. I do not know who you are. Deleted.